Hello guys, Kodouchi and welcome to another review. So this time I'm not reviewing a One Piece, but this time it's from the movie Akira. And Akira is a movie from 1988, and it's a Japanese anime movie. And that movie, Akira, made Japanese anime popular. Before Akira, Japanese anime was like, oh yeah, Japanese anime really cool. But when Akira came, it was like, yeah, Japanese anime really, really good and very cool. So I got a figure of it with a bike, as it says, Canadian bike from Akira. And a quick tour of the box. So this is where the figure sat in, and here the bike. I think this is a fantasy sticker. And the box is a bit damaged, but it's about the figure. And this is the Bandai logo, as well as a code number over there. And it says Bandai 2004 made in China. So it's a pretty old figure with its bike. So this is the back. So this is how the bike is gonna look. And this is Kaneda, the figure, the owner of the bike. Sorry for that. It's really cool. And this is a Jokoken version. So that is, it has die-cast metal parts inside of the bike. And this is the front fork. So these are the inner frame. And they are metal parts, which is really cool. Same goes with here. And in this picture, you take off all the accessory armor. And then the whole inner frame will show up, which is really cool. And for those of you who don't know, there's a story here. And I'm gonna read it out to you guys, for those who don't know Akira. In the year 2019, the world is recovering from World War III. Near Tokyo to host the next Olympics, and in preparation, redevelopment is going on at the site where the first bombs fell. Kaneda and his band of teenage motorcycle gangs enjoy making their daily carefree run across the city and causing public disturbances. During a run one day, they encounter a strange child with the number 26 tattooed on his palm. Appearing out of nowhere, the boy causes Kaneda's friend Tetsuo to crash and then vanish into thin air. Kaneda's gang are arrested and they learn that the high-level security forces are involved in the case. They were after the mysterious boy and have also taken Tetsuo away. Soon Kaneda and his friends are all swept into a conspiracy at the center of which lies the name Akira. So very cool. Very cool, they included a sort of story on the box. And without further ado, let's get a look at the figure and the motorcycle. So yeah, I'm gonna put the camera down a bit so you can see it a little bit better. Come on. Okay. So this is the bike and Kaneda. Let's start off with Kaneda first. So Kaneda is the owner of the bike, and in the anime he also said he stole it, so it's really cool. Yeah, it's Kaneda, and for a 2004 figure it's pretty well done. If you compare it to figures now, it's the figures now are far more detailed, but this is from 2004, so it's pretty nice. Nice folding effects on the clothes and shady effects as well, and he has a sort of all dirty look all over him, all over his coat. So I think that fits very well. Let's take a look at the back. So this is his famous back logo. Good for health, bad for education. And we have the gloves, which are pretty nice. The boots as well. And the only thing I found a bit weird is the arms are just glued on. So as you can see, it's not perfectly fit. As you can see, it doesn't fit perfectly. But oh well, it's from 2004. So let's put Kaneda here. It's gonna sit over there. So this is the bike, and it's the Chokoken version. So it has die-cast metal parts, so the bike is pretty heavy. And let's start off with the wheels. The wheels are made of rubber, so you can press them a bit and they will roll as well. So if you just want to play with it, you can just play with it, because the wheels move. And yeah, you can take a lot of parts off, and which I'm gonna show you. So these parts are gonna pop off, revealing the whole inner frame, like this. and even the wheel caps come off like this. Even this piece comes off, this one as well, this one, the other two wheel caps go off as well. So this is everything, all the accessories taken off, so the heart of the bike. So I'm gonna give you a quick detailed look on the inner frame, which is really cool. You can even see those screws over here. And you also have a McFarlane toy, which is made out of plastic and it's way cheaper, of course. And that one is pretty cool as well. And these parts are all made of metal. So really cool. So yeah, and you also got a digital interface here, and in the anime he says this bike has computer locked analog brakes, so it's a sort of a computer slash bike. So this is how fast he's going, this is the interface for the analog brakes and more stuff. Of course I have the handles over here, so yeah, really cool. And on the front you have the light you can put on like this. So when you're driving the bike and it's at night time, just put the light on. Oh, so really cool. And now let's put those parts back in. So like this, so this part goes onto here, I think. Oh wait, got the wrong one. This part goes onto here. This one onto here. And it fits very well and doesn't fall off, so happy about that. And you also have a really large version of the bike, which came from Bandai as well and costs around $700. But that one is also made out of, I think, metal parts, and it has sound and light effects and it's really cool. But I wanted this one because I think it's a bit too expensive for that, for what you get. So I really like this one, so I bought this one. And the wheel cap, you can put this one on front like this. But of course if you have the money for the big one, it's of course well, a good deal, I guess, but for me not so much. Okay, and then you have the wheel cap on the back, just put it in. The only thing a bit not disturbing, but is the back wheel cap is a bit at an angle, so it's not completely right, but it's not really noticeable. So yeah, okay, just put them on here and it fits. Other one as well, and it, oh come on, it fits. So yeah, so you have it like this, which looks really cool. So you get all these extra parts, and for the windshield down as well, but I like the windshield up. And what you also can do is, like when you ride the bike and you want to get off, in the anime this thing pops off and then you can just exit the bike. And very cool detail here as well, another part of the inner frame. Looks amazing. And yeah, really cool. Now let's put Kaneda on it. So I'm gonna use the bike like this. Kaneda just sits on it. Hoppa, we have it. So really cool, and you can just pose it however you want. And also on the bottom you have a sort of standard thing that you can, I hope it works. It's pretty hard to get it out though. Oh yes. The standard for the bike, so you can put it like this straight. What I always like is to put it at an angle like this, just a personal preference. And that is actually all about Kaneda's bike. And what would I rate it? Because it's a pretty old 2004, the figure is okay, and the bike I must say is amazing. And yeah, it's although it's a pretty hard to find. Actually, I found it pretty hard to find. But for the rest, it's a really cool bike. And all in all, I would give it the bike a 10 out of 10 and the figure a 8 or 7 out of 10. So I hope you like this review of Canada's bike and Canada itself, of course. And of course, I will see you guys next time in a One Piece review. So take care, guys. Bye.